masters and friends and good people, draw near and look to your purses, for that I do say. And though little money in them you do wear, it costs more to get than to lose in a day. You oft have been told, the young and the old, and bidden beware of the cut purse so bold. Then if you take heed not, free me from the curse who gave you fair warning for, and the cut purse. To men of my trade, that oftentimes we are the cause of this crime. Alack, and for pity, why should it be said, as if they regarded the place or the time? Examples have been of some that were seen in Westminster Hall, yea, the pleaders between. Then why should the judges be free from the curse, more than my poor self, for cutting the purse? At sermons and at the sessions, 'tis daily their practice such booties to make. Yea, under the gallows at executions, they stick not but stare about purses to take. Nay, once without grace at a far better place, at court and at Christmas before the king's face. Alack then for pity, must I bear the curse that only belongs to the cunning cut purse?
You thought it better be starved at nurse than for to be hanging for cutting the purse.
But, ugh, you vile nation of cut purses all, relent and repent and amend and be sound, and know that you ought not by honest men's fall to advance your own fortunes to die above ground. And though you go gay in silks as you may, it is not the highway to heaven, they say. Repent ye, repent then, for better or worse, and kiss not the gallows for